Will you notice? Verse 59, they sent away Rebekah, their sister, and her nurse, and Abraham's servant and his men, and they blessed Rebekah and said unto her, Thou art our sister, be thou the mother of thousands of millions, and let thy seed possess the gate of those which hate them. That's been fulfilled, friends, already. We're not talking now about unfulfilled prophecy. This is fulfilled. And Rebekah arose and her damsels, and they rode upon the camels and followed the man, and the servant took Rebekah and went his way. And now, will you notice, they had a long trip back. We're not told anything about that trip, but it's not easy riding a camel. I rode one from the little village there outside of Cairo down to the pyramids. And friends, that's as far as I want to ride on a camel. They call them the ship of the desert. Well, it is as rough as any trip I've ever had in a boat. It was rough, and they're not easy to ride. Imagine riding on those camels across the desert. I can see that they've had a hard day across that hot desert, and of an evening they stop at an oasis, and the campfire is built, and they have their evening meal, and they're sitting there before time to go to bed and have their sleep. And I hear Rebekah say to this servant, tell me about Isaac again. And the servant said, well, what do you want me to tell you? Tell me about the way he was born. Tell me about the way that his father offered him on the altar. Tell me the old, old story of Jesus and his love. And the servant said, well, I told that to you last night. She said, I know, but tell it again. Tell it again. And he tells it again. Never grows old. And so that night she has that sweet sleep, dreaming of the time when she'll meet this one. And then the next day they start out on the journey again, and the desert isn't quite as hot, and the camel isn't quite as rough, but it's a long ways. And so they continue. And finally, they come in sight of the land of promise. They enter it, and now they come down to Laharoi. And we read in verse 62, and Isaac came from the way of the well, Laharoi, for he dwelt in the south country, way down in the pleasant country, you see, down at Hebron and Beersheba. And Isaac went out to meditate in the field at the eventide, and he lifted up his eyes and saw, and behold, the camels were coming. Now we're given a view of the coming of Christ that we do not have. So many are saying today, won't it be wonderful when the Lord comes and we'll be caught up with him? Well, there's another view, and that's to be with him when he comes. And most of the church has already gone through the doorway of death, and they'll be coming with him when he comes, and that the bodies might be raised, and the spirit and the body joined together. Now, we read here that when he went out, they lifted up the eyes, and they saw the camels were coming. Those that are alive are to be caught up with the dead, be caught up to meet the Lord in the air. And so those that have gone before in death, they're going to see him when he rises from the right hand of the Father, and then when he starts out to call his church and to meet his church yonder in the air. This is the picture, and what a glorious picture it is. And Rebekah lifted up her eyes, and when she saw Isaac, she lighted off the camel. For she had said unto the servant, what man is this that walketh in the field to meet us? And the servant said, it's my master. Therefore she took a veil and covered herself. And we'll have to be clothed with the righteousness of Christ, but he's been made over to us righteousness. So he was delivered for our offenses, and he was raised for our justification. That is, that we might have a righteousness that would enable us to stand before God. And so she wants to know who he is, whom having not seen, we love. And I wonder today, when he does come, are we going to know him? Oh, I know there's a song, I shall know him, I shall know him by the print of the nails in his hands. And I think that's going to be the way that we're going to know him when he comes. This is the union of these two. What a glorious, beautiful, wonderful picture this is before us. Now we read in verse 66, and the servant told Isaac all things that he had done. The Holy Spirit will deliver us at the day of redemption. We've been sealed under the day of redemption. Believe me, this servant was going to get the bride to Isaac. And Isaac brought her into his mother's, Sarah's, tent. And he took Rebekah, and she became his wife. Now notice, and he loved her. The Christ loved the church and gave himself for it. And Isaac was comforted after his mother's death. And this reveals to you that Christ gains a great deal in our salvation. Oh, he wants us. He longs for us. Oh, that you and I today might be faithful to him.